It's almost two decades now since Bajaj first introduced the Pulsars, starting with the 150 and the 180, and what a raging success the brand has become. In fact, over the years, we have seen Bajaj expand the family at both ends of the spectrum. But today we have with us what is effectively the smallest Pulsar yet, the 125. Now, Bajaj tells us that this motorcycle is intended to appeal to those 125cc buyers who want a slightly sportier and more fun to ride machine than the average 125. Now, does this bike deliver on that front? Let's take a look. At first glance, it's easy to mistake the Pulsar 125 for the 150 because that's exactly what it looks like, down to the matte finish grey paint job. Of course, the 150's neon has been replaced by bright blue accents on the 125, but the styling and the body panels are exactly the same. This is a good thing, as it brings a sense of familiarity to the motorcycle and lets you recognize the 125 as a Pulsar instantly. But at the same time, I have to mention that this is exactly how the Pulsars have looked for the better part of their near two-decade existence, and the Pulsar 125 could have been a good starting point to revise the design. That said, the identicalness to its elder siblings allows the Pulsar 125 to look larger, more aggressive, and thus more imposing than most 125cc motorcycles in the country, which are very plain to look at. The Pulsar 125 thus makes a bold statement for itself and might just be a good choice for those wanting a more appealing looking 125cc machine. The engine powering the Pulsar 125 is not based on the Discover 125 engine, and in fact Bajaj tells us that this motor is essentially the Pulsar 150's motor with a shorter stroke, and that this has been done to ensure that the Pulsar 125 has the aggressive Pulsar DNA. In fact, except for its lower outputs of 12 PS and 11 Nm, the 125 feels just like the 150, including its throttle responses and the exhaust note as well. That said, the Pulsar 125's power delivery is peakier than the 150, and it also develops its peak power and torque at higher revs as compared to most 125cc commuters. Initial throttle response could have been crisper, but responses improved beyond the 3000 RPM mark. The engine allows you to build speeds quickly thereafter with its sprightlier feel, though I would have liked the power delivery to be slightly better. Clutch action at the lever is light and gears from the 5-speed gearbox slot in well, and I'm also glad that Bajaj has gone in for the more universal 1-down 4-up shift pattern and not the all-up or all-down pattern seen otherwise in the 125cc segment. The Pulsar 125 can also cross the 100 km/h mark, though it takes time to get there. But what's impressive here is the fact that while the engine feels like it is running out of breath as you go past 100 km/h, there's just some bit of vibration coming in from the foot pegs, apart from which the engine does not feel thrashy at all.
Obviously, the Pulsar 125 also borrows most of its cycle parts from its immediate sibling, the Pulsar 150, including the front telescopic forks and the two-piece handlebar. But more importantly, this bike also gets the gas-charged rear shock absorbers and the 100x90 section rear tire from the 150. And these hint at a sportier handling setup as compared to most other 125s in the country.
The Pulsar 125 thus offers the same confident feel as its immediate sibling, and it's easy to note that the 125 is a sportier handler than the average 125cc machine. And given its curb weight of 140 kilos, the Pulsar 125 is also significantly heavier than most 125s, but you barely feel the weight on the go, as the Pulsar is quick to change direction and dip into corners. That said, I would have liked the Eurogrip tyres to offer a slightly more confident feel around faster bends. What's more, given that it is a 125cc motorcycle, Bajaj has equipped the Pulsar 125 with a combined braking system and not ABS. The bike is on offer with either a front drum brake or a 240mm disc brake at the front, which is linked mechanically to the rear drum brake. Braking prowess is adequate, and the front disc brake also offers enough confidence to pull stoppies with its progressive feel, but when slowing down in traffic using the rear brake only, it takes a while to get used to the sensation of the rear drum brake also applying the front disc brake, as the disc brake obviously has more bite than the drum brakes we are used to seeing in combined braking systems. The suspension setup is on the firmer side and aids the bike's handling just like it does on other Pulsars, but at the same time, the suspension also allows the bike to soak up bumps and potholes impressively, thereby making for a good ride quality.
Now, the KTM 125 Duke and the RC 125 are great examples of how sporty a 125cc motorcycle can get in our country. Of course, the Pulsar 125 here has absolutely nothing to do with its Austrian cousins, but it does have the typical Pulsar DNA. And the Pulsars have always been a brand of motorcycles that offers great value for money, along with a sense of sportiness. And that's something that the Pulsar 125 also delivers. It feels sporty in terms of the performance and handling both as compared to a regular 125, though I would have liked a little more zing from the engine. But with that said, as a package, as a sporty 125cc everyday motorcycle, I think this motorcycle, the Pulsar 125, makes a strong case for itself.